I I you?
Good.
I knocked on your camper a while ago, but I was just going to tell you, if you want a steak, we had a bunch of steaks and potatoes.
Oh, man, I appreciate it. I'm good. I'm having fun scaring the onions right now.
Good though.
Yeah.
You got people with it yet?
Oh yeah, I've already got the both hay riders come by so far.
Well,
and then of course when it gets a little darker, I'll try to get some kids with it. Right now I'm just mainly focused on the hay riders, and then he stops right here, he's perfect. You know, yeah. They don't need it. It looks good.
Are you here permanently?
This year I've been here since April.
Okay. I know we've seen you up here before.
Right. Yeah, I've been coming the last 3 years, but this is the first year I've done 6 minute left turn and 7 minute stretch.
Okay. Where do you normally live?
Well, I'm over North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Yeah, I actually leave next week. Depending on the weather, I mean, I'm here till the camper leaves Thursday, but the way the weather's looking over, it might go before that.
Yeah, I mean, it's
so I was going to wait till Halloween Day to leave to take his home and everything and go do that. Come back the next day, and then I'd have a day of sort of rest there, and then I'd go home and camp to close the morning, but I might change that. I'm gonna wait and see what they're saying about the clump of snow and all kinds of stuff.
Plus it's cold. I know.
And I don't really care to have to get up in 20-some degrees picking up the leaf.
I
don't like cold.
No. I thought I seen your dog out here earlier.
Yeah, she's in the camper right now.
Oh, she's just pulling things out the camper.
Yeah, she doesn't know where the AC's at the moment.
So she's smart, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Now is that Tootsie there?
Yeah, that's
okay.
Tootsie.
Okay.
That's who Tootsie is. I like y'all's little setup.
Yeah, that's the live shows. We usually come up here every Halloween.
Right.
I mean,
I know last year I was up in Jay Brown.
Yeah. Yeah.
And of course I was dressed up, but I didn't feel like I didn't want to leave here and go home and get my costume because I forgot to bring it back with me when I was at home there for the beach wise. And I just didn't feel like driving over and driving back to get that, so I came up with this idea. So I could have some fun.
That's good.
Instead of being, you know, dressed up, because I know last year I'd get them when they come by on the hay ride. I'd pop out.
Oh, yeah.
But,
yeah, you
ain't living without that phone, can you?
No. I tell you, these kids now.
Yeah, I know it. That's what I like about seeing them here, because we're either riding around or
doing
something
besides just
right here.
I know. Luckily, usually she'll, if it's in the evenings or something, like we're eating, she'll be up.
Right.
Like you said, we're here, as you usually
are. Right.
But
running around playing around with it.
That's God. I bet you lost people in this year.
Well, they did bother me, and I guess they had a pencil with them, but they left because they didn't be home to church in the morning. So, I mean, I can understand that. But with all the stuff they had, I'm probably going to be done for this.
Yeah.
pretty nice.
I was still trying to figure out where they fit everybody. That was a lot of people.
Well, one was like a semi-park model.
Oh, was
the
it?
The one that said you might miss like a
connector. Oh, right.
He picked up the whole thing, and the big turn was right at the edge. And it's not as big as the park model that's in behind this one. He was in that, but that's still fine. But it was similar, you know, it was a new community park model. And it still had the flying board. But that's what fake was all three of these, them two that was in that spot, and then the crowd that was in the sea,
yeah,
right across from y'all.
Yeah, I see. That's awesome. And like you said, I mean, that seems like a lot just to come for, what, a day and a half, pretty much?
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, we're local. I mean, it takes us 15 minutes to get here.
Right.
Yeah, we came in.
They said it's 2 hours to leave, which is a little bit shorter than me, because it's 3 to me, 4.
That's the Park Carolina?
Hickory.
Yeah. It's funny, because half the time, it seems, I remember back, you know, even 20 years ago, all the campers
kind of
the same now. Some of these
things,
these campers cost
more than,
you know.
Well, I know. Well, when I first started camping fishing, I'd get 40 lead people
wanting
to come look at stuff because it's just
Oh, no, it's, I mean.
You know, it's, I mean, everybody talks spaceship. And I still get something with the boats, but not like I was. Because I've had it 4 years now.
I'll tell you though, it's neat how they can take everybody and put it in the
right. That kitchen in the back, when I used to find out about that kitchen in the back, that's amazing.
That's
cool. Where the propane tanks at, and they put a smaller propane tank and put it on the side, back in the back corner. I can't remember which side, but it's a cassette toilet that goes right there now. The ones that make it back.
That's neat. Yeah, that's crazy. Because you know, back in the day, to get concrete, you had to have a pop-out.
Right.
You know, and they
right.
just, and then you go
out. And I didn't want to go to pop-out route, because I know any time it rains, you got to let that mess dry. And it's a whole lot more work. I wanted something quick, easy to where I was sitting by a fire in 10 minutes.
Well, you know,
because when I bought it, I was still working. And I knew I was just going to have fire that Saturday night. So I wanted set up real quick.
But like you said, I mean, when we started out years and years ago, we had a pop-up.
Right.
You know, we were camping in Florida. And the crank messed up on it.
No, yeah.
So,
too.
You know, you had to have somebody come out and fix it so we
right.
could put it down.
Right.
And so I was like, I don't want to run into that again. So, you know, we ended up just getting a small, it was like an 18-foot camper.
Right.
And when the kids got bigger, like, we outgrew that quick. So.
Right.
But, you know, it's just crazy. I mean, all these campers, they have 3, 4, 5 slide outs.
Oh,
yeah,
I know it is.
It's crazy.
You're right.
I mean, and like, you know, I was saying, I mean, at some of these RVs, and they have many dollars for
anything. They had it done north here months ago, and he had put half down on what the thing was going to cost for. His height he put down, what he told us, was like 1.8, I think is what he said, so just shy of a $4 million temple that rolled in here.
I mean, even if I had that kind of money, why would you want to spend it on something like that? If I had that kind of money, I'd have property at different areas.
Right.
I'd
rather have a cabin or something versus that.
I want if I had that kind of money, I would have property with a house, cabin, whatever,
I mean,
and be able to just fly to it.
Right,
you know?
that too, and I mean, unless if you're hauling a bunch of people, why would you want something that big to drive around? And then you got to maintain it on top of that. I mean, like I said, though, he's got the money to pay it away, I guess.
I mean, you know as well as I do, campers, RVs, they depreciate.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Quickly.
That's the reason I'm not ever going to go bigger.
No.
I'll go to like a tiny home or something of that nature. Or a whole value.
But the thing is, something like that will hold us back. Because, you know, there's not a whole lot of them.
Right.
And they're compact, so they don't have as much stress.
Well, there's no maintenance to it either.
It's
all aluminum, so there's nothing. The only thing that I'd really have to replace would be microwave, maybe the heat and air, the trimmer. That's about it, really.
Oh, yeah.
And great.
But that's still, everything you just said is still cheaper than a payment on one of those new ones.
Right.
You know, I mean, so it's, and that's all you need.
Well, yeah, that's all I need. Now, yeah, if I had a family, I wouldn't be able to do it. I know, that's why something changes. Other than that, I'll stick with this because when I came last year and I've done the month of May, I mean, May flew by and I had a ball and this didn't aggravate me or nothing. So then I stayed August and September last year, and then this year I told them I wanted 6 months, which turned into seven.
So what kind of rate did they give you for staying?
It's monthly rate.
It's monthly rate. What are they charging you?
It's a monthly rate, like 14.
Okay.
But now if you're yearly, you get it even cheaper.
If you add it up.
But I can't die. I mean, I'm not going to be here in the wintertime. I'd have November, December, January, February. I'd have 4 months there that I wouldn't be using. So it really is not worth it to do the yearly, yearly rate.
And I mean, like you said, I mean, going a while, I mean, even if you rented an apartment down here, that's still cheaper than an apartment.
Oh, yeah.
And to you, so water, electric, included, right? So, I mean,
internet, you've got it all included.
It's no brainer, really.
Yeah, all things you're really paying for is gas and the insurance and whatever other bills that you might have.
Yeah.
That's it.
Well, go ahead.
But like I said, though, if I was to start standing full time, yeah, I definitely have to get something bigger though, because I do crazy in the wintertime not being able to move around
anymore.
There's not enough that goes on here, especially come January and February. There's nothing really goes on here in people afford enough to justify, because the days were so cold, and get out there and venture out. Ride the golf cart around without freezing your tail off. That's not fun to me.
No, and like you said, I mean, unless you're one of these people that's into hiking year round or stuff like that, that's one thing. But like you said, in the cold winter months, unless you do find stuff to do indoors, there's nothing to do.
Right.
So, but hey.
Well, other than if it snows and you've got to ski and snowboard and stuff like that, that's about it.
I'll be honest, I can tell you, I've only been in Gatlinburg. We try to stay out of Gatlinburg. It's just so crowded.
It's been
up there
a while since I've been in Gatlinburg.
It's just so crowded.
Well, it is right now because of the leaves.
But, we're not hackers and stuff like that.
Right.
So, I mean, we don't, Well, we'll get over here and check on Dave. It was good talking to you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yes,
I'm David, by the way.
All right, David, nice to meet you, David.
You're Jeff.
Yep. That's right. Checking this mask out right quick.
on there.
Yeah.
And Andy know about it.
No, 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 it's one of them.
Thank you.
That's right. Yep, I was in the parade.
There's a really good
parade. Hey, you want
to race? Nah, I'm gonna hang out right here for just a little bit.
Daddy, she was trying to
circle. Oh, really?
All right, happy Halloween, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and end the video. Not as much action going on now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next go around.